Icons are appropriated and used to designate consciousness and meaning, particularly posthumously.
And what brings all those people together?
They're all people that died for a cause. They're all people whose icons are used to designate meaning, perhaps not in the manner in which they intended.
A wise man once said, an error doesn't become a mistake until you refuse to correct it.
Society is lying, some fat, others thinner than to make you feel divided. No sides, just middlemen. Violence happens every single day, nobody give a damn. We forget we all equal from Trayvon to Zimmerman. And to me, that's really what the fuss is about. We trust a system that lets peers say this stuff is allowed. Fact is, a boy was killed trying to walk to his house, and a grown man walked claiming he was standing his ground. So to find justice, notice the crime and a prime suspect. Open your mind up, travel to mine, that's why I'm upset. And if you gotta throw race in, then enough said. That alone perpetuates hate and fear in a public. But shit, I guess you'll do what you do. I'm just tired of dodging bullets that are shot from the news. I'm young, I'm trying to live and get it popping, my dude. But then a tragedy strikes and we all gotta choose. We still can't see past the face. What kind of place do we live in? We bring up hate when youth pass away. Newsflash, today ain't changed much since the past, kid. Thought shit was dead, but you buried a hollow casket. Honestly, I'm hoping that we can hobble past it. Maybe unite as men and make actual actions. But the way we headed right now, it ain't happening. Can't live in peace and harbor hate for inhabitants. So unity's the only way to go. Stop seeing color first and take a look at the soul. Then ask yourself who'd be easier to control, a group fighting each other or one with a common goal. Notice the scene in the plot, same stage, new actors. It's a play that they watch, swear it's a plague. How they are stationed on top and looking at the world today, it's almost painful to watch. Look, and yet the reel spins 60 frames a second. Try looking away and your sights redirected. Life dreams neglected, you're a slave to your tax bracket. Slave to your wage and payday, you a crack addict. Pay your bills and you back at it. Making this rainy day fun for some dreams you're not grasping. Seems like a scheme to me, I lay back with the greenery. Smoke it, go hit and shake my head at today's scenery.
No official of my administration, whether his rank is high or low, civilian or military, should interpret my words here tonight as an excuse to censor the news, to stifle dissent, to cover up our mistakes, or to withhold from the press and the public the facts they deserve to know.
You know what happens if you work in media? People like to change the information so that it suits a particular agenda.
Preparations are concealed, not published. Its mistakes are buried, not headlined. Its dissenters are silenced, not praised. No expenditure is questioned, no rumor is printed, no secret is revealed. I am asking your help in the tremendous task of informing and alerting the people.
People are very, very intelligent, but the information gets manipulated a lot, and people like to cause, like, you know, fake stirs and stuff.
For it is no longer far away and foreign, but close at hand and local.
People of America, we're going to be okay. Everything's all right. These are your trusted anchors.